If you liked our video, please give a thumbs up to this video and also subscribe to our channel. And today we will make use of this paper from the 2019 October series to talk about the IGCSE, okay, accounting. So the topic today we will focus on is about the journal. So I would like to make use of this video and this question paper to take a look, okay. So what are the main points, okay, and what are the common mistakes made by candidates? So let's take a look part A. So for part A, we have to prepare the sales journal account and also the sales return journal, okay. Now, I have put the answer in the middle of this video. So this is the answer for part A, and this is also the video, this is also the answer for part A. So let's take a look each point. So first of all, we will take a look at August 6th. So it talks about there is a sales to Kala. So this one, okay, we will put it, okay, in the sales journal. But when you put it in the sales journal, you have to be very careful. The value is not 1,400 because there is a trade discount. So what we need to do, we need to deduct the discount to get the net value. So I would say it's not difficult to compute the answer. So let's take a look. So for this one, this 208, or how to compute this one, so it's about 20% discount. So this one will be 1400 times 20%. Then it will be equal to 280. So that's the discount. So, and then we can grab the net value, 1120. Let's move on to the second one. The second one is about Kala returns some of the goods sold. Okay, so for this one, be careful, it's not 300, but 240. Because you have to realize that, okay. So this one, this return is from this good. So also, that's why we have to deduct the second again. So let me put it this way. So these two, they are indeed relate to each other. So let's mark that down. This one, okay, they are indeed related to each other. So right now we will move on to the next part. For the next part is about sold goods. Okay, sold goods to Nikia 620. Then you put it here. That's very easy. On 24th, they return 1/4. So what is the meaning of 1/4? That means 1/4. Okay, 1/4. 1/4. Okay, or you may say it's a 25%, okay? It's both acceptable. So right now when you do this, okay, it's this 60, so you make a 1/4, so that is 155, okay? I will put down the formula. So the formula will be 620 divided by 4. That is 1/4. Then you will get 155. Great. Now let's move on. So for this one, sold goods to Kala 160. Then you put it back to here. So it's not difficult. Now what we need to do next is not the end. So because let's read the question again. So in the question, we need to prepare the total for each journal and indicate the ledger accounts, okay? So right now, we will try to compute this part, okay? So for this part, what we need to do, we need to add these up. Add these up, then you can grab 1,900 as the total. So let's take a look at the sales journal, sales returns journal. So you try to add up 240 and 155. Then you will get 395 to be transferred to sales returns account. So that's all for part A. Right now, we will move on to part B. So for part B, we have to prepare three accounts, including Kala account, the sales account, and the sales returns account. I have put the answer in the middle of the video. So this one is the answer for part B. This one is the answer for part B. And also on the right top corner of the video, so there's also one answer for part B. Right now, so let's take a look how to do that. So first of all, you can see they have provided the balance spot down. So this balance spot down 900 is grabbed from the top of the question here, okay? So the color is a customer, they own us 900. So this 900, so you can put it here, okay? So on the other hand, so this 21400 is not given in the question. So okay, so they give us here, okay? So the total return is also not given, okay? So is balance spot down from the previous part. So right now we try to make use of these figures to try to finish the T account. Let's get started. Now first of all, I would put this 1900 in the sales account. Okay? Yep. So and also I will put the 395 as indicated here. Okay, I will pick one color. Okay, I will use this 395 to put it here. Okay, so we can just transfer the balances to there. Okay, so it's not that difficult. And then you can compile the income statement. Okay, by here, by adding up these two, then you can grab this one. You add up these two, then you can grab this one. So let me do the arrow for you. So you add these two up, then you can have this one. Okay, on the other hand, if you add for the sales returns account, when you try to add these two up, okay, then you will have this one. So it's not that difficult at all. Okay, it's not difficult at all. So this is how we do that. Now so let's go back to the color account. So this one is the most difficult one, so let's do this one by one. Okay, so first of all, we have to take a look at the transactions. So this one with color's name, this one is also with color's name, and this one with also with color's name. So I will make use of these three, number one, number two, and number three, and try to compute, okay, the color account. So let's take a look at the first one. So this one is called 1120. So I will put this 1120 to here. It's not that difficult at all. Also, this one is 160, so I will put it here. So I will try to grab these two value to here. So okay, so I will mark it down for you. So this one, we have this one, we also have this one. Then we will put it to here. Now, next, so what we need to do is to take a look another account in the sales returns. So in the sales returns, we had two. So we have one. Okay, this is 240. So we will put this 240 to here, right? We should put this 240 to here. So that's it. Okay, so that's it. Now, the last item we need to focus is this one. Okay, so let's take a look here on the video top left. So the guy has settled the balance due on August 1. So let's take a look, what is the balance? So this is 900, right? So 900 with 2% discount. So we can work out the math. So 900 with 2% discount. So the discount would be $18. So this one would be the discount. So you can put the discount here. Okay. So and then the repayment will be AA2. So that's very easy, right? So how to grab this AA2? So I will show you. So it will be 900 minus the $18 as the discount. Then you will get AA2 as the repayment. Good. Now, after you grab all these, then you can compute the balance carry down, okay? As 1040. So you try to add up 900, 1120, and 160, and then minus 240, minus 882, and minus 18. Then you can get the balance carry down as 1040. So this would be the balance carry down. And you put it here as the bot down. So that's all for part B, okay? That's all for part B. One thing I would like to remind you, that is when you try to close the account, okay? So let's take a look at the question again. Now when you try to close the account, you have to do balancing it or making it transfer to the income statement. So what does that mean? Okay, so that means say for example, for the Kyla account. So this Kyla account would be a real account, okay? So as a real account, of course, so there would be, this is a real account, so there is the balance, okay? There would be a balance brought down. But for the sales account, okay? For sales account, this one, so we call it a nominal account. So you have to transfer it to the income statement. And also look at the right top corner. So for the sales return account, it's also a nominal account. So that's why we have to close it by transferring to the income statement. So be careful, okay? So differentiate. So I would say you have to differentiate balancing or making a transfer. So for balancing, it would be for the real account to do so. For transferring to the income statement, would be for the nominal account, like sales and sales return. So you have to close it and put it back to the nominal account. So next, okay, so this is all for part B. Next, I would like to move on to C1. Okay, C1, I've put the answer here, okay, on the right middle, okay, in the video, as you can see in the red dots. So let's take a look at what happened in C1. So it's talk about, okay, 2% cash discount is allowed, okay, if they settle their accounts within 30 days. So right now, okay, she's trying to reduce the credit period to 21 days, okay, and reduce the cash discount to 1%. So what would happen to the profit, okay? What would happen to the profit? Of course, okay, so there are a lot of profit it might do. So first of all, you may talk about it may have positive effect or negative effect to the answer. Okay, so this one, so these are for the positive effect. And on the other hand, there might be negative effects to the profit. It depends, okay? It depends. So let's take a look. What happened, okay? So I would like to, first of all, focus on the increase in profit. So why there is an increase in profit? Because you give less, okay? You give less discount, okay? So of course, you have less expenses, then you can grab higher profit, okay? So on the other hand, you might face decreasing profit because the customer may go to other suppliers for better terms. So you might answer either one for the answer. Now, let's take a look at the last question. Okay, so I'll put the last question on the middle top of this video. It talks about, okay, how would it affect the liquidity? Again. So in this type of question, you may answer either the positive effects, okay, the positive effects, or the negative effects in your answer, okay? So let's take a look what are the negative effects at first. Now for the negative effect, it talks about the customers may take longer, okay? May take longer. That means they won't, okay? They will take longer period to repay the cash, okay? Because they don't have the incentive anymore. So this is the effect on the liquidity. On the other hand, you may talk about, okay, so the 21 days period has reduced, okay? So they will pay quicker as the credit period reduced from 30 days to 21 days. So they pay quicker, so then you have a better liquidity. So both answers are accepted, okay? So that's all for this video. Okay, please give a thumbs up to this video and subscribe to our channel.